What's up, everybody? This is Jim Martin from Captivation Media, and this is Fist Pump Friday. Here we are, our first episode ever of Fist Pump Friday. We're super excited to be delivering this to you guys, and we really appreciate all of your help and support over the last month here as we've been sending out those emails and you've been providing that feedback back to us using that pump@captivationmedia.com email address. We're really excited to be bringing this to you. Again, we're going to be doing this at the end of the month, every single month, providing additional questions and answers for you. And so just keep sending in those questions for us. And with that, let's get into our first question. So we get a lot of people asking this question lately, if they're thinking about maybe going with the WordPress solution for their website, but then they also see these free website builders that are out there, and there's a number of them on the market. So I won't specifically go into any one in particular, but there's a couple of things in terms of our particular stance on that that we really want you to think about. Obviously, from our standpoint, I'm an agency owner. We build a lot of stuff in WordPress. We're very big into the WordPress community and we support them heavily. So there's a lot of support around that community. There's also a lot of infrastructure around that from a hosting perspective and everything else, which gives you the ability to really be flexible in terms of who's working on your site. So it's something where if your current web developer is building you a site in WordPress and you don't really like how that's going, or you don't like where the site is hosted, maybe it's too slow, you can easily take that WordPress site and transfer it to another host or transfer it to another service provider that's going to give you better service. But from a standpoint of these other drag and drop solutions, you're really married to that whole universe whether you like it or not. So although it seems super easy, and that's the whole point, is that they want to get you in on how easy it is for that system to be set up. But then if you ever want to move that someplace else, you're really stuck. And so something to really consider, and also think about all of the anonymous data that might be tracking on the back end of the site that you don't even have access to, that those people are getting about you and your visitors. So food for thought. From our standpoint, WordPress is the way to go. And with that, let's go into our next question. So as we talk about effective e-blasts, I think about the days of AOL, and you remember that, I'm sure. And obviously, aside from that crazy sound that you hear when you are logging in, what you lived for was to hear that guy say, "You've got mail." And back in the day, we didn't have Instagram, we didn't have Facebook, we didn't have Snapchat, and all of these other things that were taking our attention away from just plain old email. So your email got a lot more attention, and just about all of those emails that you would receive were from people that you wanted to hear from. Now we've got so much spam, so much white noise coming to our inbox from so many different places that in many cases your emails don't even get opened by the people that you send them to. So there's a couple of components that we need to be talking about here in terms of effectively sending e-blasts. For most of you, you want to make sure that you have and have confirmed that you have double opted in emails. This means that people have signed up on your website or signed up through another landing page or something like that, and then have received some kind of a confirmation email to make sure that they have to click something that says, "Yes, I've entered my information here and I've also confirmed on this link that I want to hear from you." So that will help ultimately your open rates and your engagements, because you're not just going out and spamming a bunch of people that don't really want to hear from you anyway. So that's a big thing. Secondly, you want to be looking at the subject line of your emails, and that's something that we could do an entire Fist Pump Friday email about, is just writing those effective bylines that are going to be associated with your content. And not all content needs to be really salesy or really in your face that way, but it's something that from a standpoint of putting things out there, you really have to start defining what your win is and what type of person do you want to read that email and what are they going to respond most heavily to when that enters their inbox. So as it relates to that, making sure that you have a super effective double opted in list with a really good byline to get people into that e-blast is something that will be the first step of our game. That's getting them to open it is step one. From there, we want to make sure that we have content that's engaging and that means something to them. So If you have a list that you're able to segment into different verticals as it's pertinent to your business, then you want to make sure to do that, and that the content, the writing, the imagery, it's all going back to the individual that you're trying to attract and that you're trying to reach, so that when they do open it, yeah, okay, this is pertinent to me. This is something that I can get behind. And so you put a lot of your, you front load a lot of your interesting, most useful information at the top, because as people are looking at these things on their mobile phone, you want to make sure all of those things are optimized, by the way, so that they show up that way. But you also want to make sure that when they're reading it, that it does want to pull them down through the rest of that content. So that's super important. And then from there, again, we're defining our wins. So if it's something where it's just a general email that's giving somebody information, or if it's something where you're trying to entice somebody to buy your product or learn more about something, you want to drive them into that funnel. You want to drive to the sale. You want to drive to that call to action. So having a very clear, very easy to understand call to action, and for them to infer exactly where they're going to be taken as a result of clicking that email is also really super helpful. So I think if this is something that you guys want to dive into deeper, shoot me an email at pump@captivationmedia.com and we'll be able to kind of go into that a little bit more. But as you can see, there's a lot of layers to that onion, and it's constantly changing in terms of how to make sure that your emails are opened, that they're not ending up in spam, and that they're actually driving revenue for your company. And these are things that we can continue to talk about over the coming weeks. So that does it for this month's Fist Pump Friday webisode. Again, first episode, thank you for joining us. Thank you for making it all the way to the end here. We appreciate your support. We appreciate you taking a look at this, and hopefully this information is helpful to you. It's something that I'm hoping that as we build this over the coming weeks, that this is something where we're really driving content based on what you want to hear about. So it's super important that you continue to send those emails to pump@captivationmedia.com. We'll continue to respond back to them. And the more we hear of your questions, the more we're going to include them in the show. So have a great rest of your month, and we'll look forward to talking to you next month.